Adobe has made some fantastic changes to Photoshop 2019 and also to Lightroom, and I'm going to show you my top five changes that they have made, especially coming from the viewpoint of a landscape photographer. Hi, my name is Tim Shields. I'm a landscape photographer and I create videos to help you take your photography from good to great. In this video, I'm going to show you my top five upgrades to Photoshop, the 2019 version, especially from the landscape photography perspective. And if this is the type of video content that you like to see, then I would ask that you hit the red subscribe button and the little bell beside it so that you'll be notified when I have new tutorial videos uploaded. So let's jump right in and look at Photoshop and Lightroom changes for 2019. All right, so to get started, you need to update your Adobe Creative Cloud. You know the drill on this. Open up Adobe Creative Cloud, and it shows Photoshop CC, and what I'm interested in is down here, Lightroom Classic CC. So I'm updating now. I just click the update button. I cannot have my Lightroom open while I'm doing the update. And as soon as I'm done that, I'm going to update Camera Raw CC and then update Photoshop CC. Those are the top three priorities for me. All right, the install is done. So let's open up Lightroom. I'm going to show you the first upgrade in Lightroom, and then I will show you the same one in Photoshop. This for me is a very exciting upgrade. Finally, within Lightroom and Photoshop, we are now able to create an HDR panorama in one smooth movement. So I have a single row panorama that I have selected all the photos from right across the bottom. And I'm thinking there must be about seven different camera movements here with three photos each. So maybe there are around 21 files. So I've selected them. I right click. I go to Photo Merge HDR Panorama. And now Lightroom is going to pull up this display here, and I can, as per usual, choose spherical, cylindrical, or perspective. I find that for landscapes, cylindrical is usually my go-to. And I'm just going to pause the processing because it's going to take a while. These are massive files from a Nikon D850, 46 megapixels each. So I'm going to pause. We'll be right back when it's done. Okay, so the preview has been rendered and I've got it in cylindrical. So I have two options here. The first one is boundary warp. I like boundary warp because if I'm trying to save the edges, maybe I've cropped in a little bit too close and I want to add some sky. If you select boundary warp, move up this slider, it actually warps the image at the edges so that it'll fill in any missing gaps. Now, if I don't want to use boundary warp, I can choose this option here, which is auto crop. Just click that and it crops the existing image. So for this particular one, I'm not needing to add any additional sky. I'm going to use auto crop and I'm going to click merge. And now Lightroom is creating the full size HDR image. This is actually, it really is super exciting because the old way of doing this, I won't even get into it. It was so cumbersome and time consuming. And I ended up buying additional software to be able to do this. So this is just a fantastic feature that Adobe has included with this update for Lightroom and Photoshop. Now let's do the same thing again super quickly in Photoshop. So step one on this is to open up the files that I want to use for this particular HDR panel. And it's actually a surprisingly simple process. Select the photos that I want, click open, and they are going to be stacked up on the left-hand side in the raw editor. Now I select all, Control A or Command A, right click, merge to HDR panorama. It is essentially as simple as that. The process now is going to be very similar to what we already saw in Lightroom. And the preview image has now been rendered. So I have two options. in order to deal with cropping right off the bat. And just like in Lightroom, I can use the boundary warp, which somewhat stretches the outer corners of the image in order to make it fit. Or I can use auto crop, which that would be applicable for me in this case. There is a button here that I can use that says apply auto tone and color adjustments. I don't like to use any auto color adjustments for anything in Lightroom or Photoshop, so I'm not going to use that. And then for the projection options, I have spherical, cylindrical, and perspective. Perspective, I essentially never use in landscapes. Spherical, I rarely use, and cylindrical, I most always use. Cylindrical adds a little extra height to what's going on in the background there, and that's what I want. So now I'm going to select merge and save, and now Photoshop is chewing on the large file and creating it, and it should be done in about a minute. The second update to Lightroom 2019 that I really like is the ContentAware Fill tool. Now, take a look down in the river here. I painted in a white dot, and let's just say there's a boat down there and we don't want to see that boat. So what we can do is grab the lasso tool, and actually I'm just going to zoom in just a touch so that this will be even bigger. And I have got the lasso tool selected, and I want to make this thing go away. So let's circle it with the lasso tool. So what I want to do is go to Edit and then select ContentAware Fill. And what it shows me is a preview on the right-hand side of what the fix is going to look like. Now, I just did a couple of practice sessions, and in the previous practice session, it did not do such a perfect job. This is kind of funny because it's like it knew everybody was watching. And this time around, it did a fantastic job. So let's just do this again. Ah, kind of screwed that up. And go Edit, ContentAware Fill. And it did a perfect job again. That is the strangest thing. So what I was doing before is it was incorporating some land into the area that it was fixing. And so I had a chunk of land right here. So the fix for it is that everything that is green is used as the sample area to create this fix. So if I hold down the mouse, I'm removing the land from the sample area so that the only thing left from the sample area is the water. And then that way I can be sure that my resulting repaired image is going to be only water. So there it is. And if you look on the side here in the sample preview pane, which is brand new, of course, you can see that it's a very good fix. There we go there. So, and then the other way around is if you hold the Alt button to the plus, and if I was to say, I only want this area that I'm now painting to be the sample area, so I could subtract this area up here and that area from the side, and let's take a look at what it did for us. And that looks great too. So again, if I use the plus, holding down Alt, and only selected this up here and then deselect the water, you're going to see that the opposite effect comes in, and it's obviously not what I want. It's putting land in the middle of the river. So I want the opposite. I want to hold down Alt. I want this to be the sample area where I'm going to do the repair from. I want this white dot removed, and then remove this here. And now we see the preview pane. It's a perfect fix. And my big white blob is gone. So if I click OK, that's done. So the next thing that Adobe has added to Photoshop 2019 is the ability to go backwards, to step back after you've made an error. Now, typically, I had to hold down, if I wanted to step back 2 points or step back 3 steps, 4 steps, I had to hold down Control Alt Z or Z, Control Alt Z. or Control Command Z if you're using a Mac. But in this case, finally, with this update, I don't know why this one has taken so long. We can just go Control Z, Control Z, and step backward as many steps as we want. And I'm going back through all the steps in my history palette. And I love this. So now I don't have to hold down Control and Alt. The fourth fantastic improvement to Photoshop 2019 is the adjustments and changes to the transform tool. So let's take a look at this situation. I have two layers here and we're looking at the top layer. And let's say I want to reduce the size of the top layer. And I'm going to do that using transform. So I hold down Control T. And normally when I grab one of the corners and start to move it, everything would go out of proportion. I would lose my aspect ratio. But now they have included it so that the default is that the aspect ratio will stay the way that it is. I actually really like this change. So I can even grab the image from the side and pull it in, and the aspect ratio will remain constant. If I want to play around with the aspect ratio, I just hold down the shift key, grab it from the side, and then I can warp it however way I want to, just like before. So I actually welcome this change. I'm clicking Control Z to go back, but I really like this change because it's just one less thing I have to worry about when I'm clicking and dragging. So it's a nice option. So the number five, the fifth new feature with Adobe Photoshop 2019 is the changes that they made to the layer blending modes. So we're taking a look at the top layer at the moment, and we can see the blending modes. And now when I mouse over the different blending modes, I'm on color burn, linear burn, darker color, lighten, screen, color dodge. You can see that the effect is being applied right before your eyes, so you don't have, so you can just see it instantly. I think that this is a fantastic upgrade for Photoshop 2019. So these are my top five changes to Photoshop 2019. It is a big deal when we consider that the HDR panorama has been added. This changes everything from a landscape photographer's perspective. So if you enjoyed this video, I would ask that you hit the red subscribe button and hit that little bell beside it so you'll be notified whenever I upload a new training and tutorial video. As well, please give the video a thumbs up if you liked it. And here's the question of the day. What do you think of these changes that Adobe has made to Photoshop and Lightroom? Do you like them? Is it enough? Or are there other changes that you would like to see that Adobe makes? Thanks so much. See you in the next video.